the Lord, saints, and welcome to our broadcast, My New Beginnings. We are New Beginnings Ministry. I'm Pastor Teresa McCurry, and my husband is Senior Pastor Gregory McCurry. And today, I'm down here in Children's Church because it's a little chilly outside, and they are starting worship upstairs. But we want to invite you into the sanctuary today. Pastor Greg will be bringing forth a powerful word entitled, Only Believe. You know what? They call us believers, but the question is, do you truly believe? Do you believe everything that the Word of God says from Genesis to Revelation? Because if you're a true believer, the answer to that question is yes, you do believe. So come on and join us right now and listen to this powerful word from Senior Pastor Gregory McCurry, Only Believe.
Amen. Hallelujah. I want you to go park over in Ephesians as we begin to walk through what the Lord has given me today. Because I believe if we could just start believing, we can begin to see miracles like we have never seen before. The Lord is right now about to take away some impossibilities in your life. Brother Tim, if you can just believe. That is the problem with us today. Amen. Is that we say we are believers, but we really don't believe. We say we believe in Jesus, but do we believe in His Word? I talk to many people and many times, and the one thing that I'm always trying to convince people of is that God's Word is true.
Yes.
And God's Word, it stands all by itself.
Right.
Yes. Angie, whether you believe it or not, the Word is the Word.
Yes.
And you can't even make it lie if you try to.
All right.
Because it stands by itself.
Yes.
See, when there's truth, nothing can come against truth, because even when a lie comes, a lie dissipates. Because, Brother Archie, the truth gonna stand no matter what.
Yes.
And we got to get to the point, people of God, that we begin to believe what God is saying. And not what He's just saying, but what He's saying to the Bible. Hallelujah, somebody. He's just not saying something, Jason. He's trying to tell you right now, people of God, if you don't believe nothing else, we are living in the last of the last of the last days here on earth. Amen, somebody. He's trying to say it is time for Him to come alive in your life. Amen, somebody. It is time, Deacon Walker. It's time. The world has all the publicity that it wants to have, but the church is sitting back letting the world take over. And it's time for the body of Christ to stand up. Tell your neighbor, it's time to stand up. It's time to stand up. Hallelujah, somebody. And I came by to remind you again of just a few things before we get started. Me and my wife were talking on this morning, and I said, baby, every day, every Sunday, I get up, God tell me to start off with the same thing. Amen. And I sometimes you say, Lord, why? And He said, don't ask me why, just do it. Because there's somebody that's sitting in here today that is wondering whether God really loves you. And I come out to tell you, despite of everything you have done, everything you're thinking about doing, everything you might do, or everything you just did, God said He still loves you. Man, right there, right there. No. Turn to Him and say, He loved you. He loved you. He loved you. Yes, He do. He loved. Listen, God don't care on what you did. Amen. God took care of your sin. Gonna do. Well, really, what I'm talking to right loves me. And then when she said this, Brother Jason, she said, but who would ever thought that I would love him like I, who would ever thought that I would have loved him like I love him? I knew he loved me, but who would ever thought a wretch like me could love such a holy God like him? Tell your neighbor, he loved you, he loved you. Revelation of his love for you to change your whole life. See, because until you had an encounter with love, you will stay the same way. Now, I'm not talking about an encounter with religion, but I'm talking about an encounter with Jesus that will forever change your life. There was a man, and his name was Saul, and he had an encounter with Jesus, and that one encounter, God changed his name and changed his claim. See, you don't know. All it takes is one day. One day, your past, your future, and that thing with Jesus can change in one day. Your past can come your future. Your future can come your past. And your right now will disappear. Because now, tell your neighbor, it's about to be disappearing after a minute. Loves me. Amen. Because I read the scriptures. Y'all been in VBS and all those other places. They say St. John 3:16. That scripture has become numb to us. Because we've heard it so long that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. And we stay there stuck on that scripture. But one day I was messing around reading in the book of Romans. Around the 5th chapter. And I didn't never know it was there in that. He said, why? Yet. No, I ain't talking about, I'm talking about why I was yet now. See, I understood now that his love was still in place while I was yet. Well, y'all catch that in a minute. I said while I was yet doing what I was doing, he still decided he was going to lay down and rise again while I was in my yet mess. Anybody ever been in a yet mess? And he wouldn't let me go. Ain't that a mess? Roger, I got mad at him. This is when I found out he was real. All right. Anybody ever been mad at God before?
Oh, yeah.
I got mad at God. And I told God, Angie, you better not ever say nothing to me again.
All right.
Because see, when you angry, you say stuff.
Right.
You don't mean.
That's right.
And God came in and started talking to me more. Than he ever talked to me before. And he kept on nudging me and saying, I love you, boy. Get yourself back in me. I love you. I was out trying to do wrong.
Come on.
Anybody trying to do wrong. And God wouldn't even let me do wrong. And I told him, leave me alone. I'm talking to somebody in right now. You can be trying to do the wrong thing, and God's love will come in and rescue you. I tried to pick up a girl on the street.
Come on.
She got in my car and said, you want a date? I said, I sure do. She looked at me and said, you the police, and jumped out of my car. Damn, that's what God will do for you. Oh, I ain't said to me, you can be mad at me all you want, but Greg McCurry, I still love you. And I come out to tell new beginners today, I don't care what you've done. I don't care where you've been. I don't care what you're thinking about doing. God told me to tell you today in my television listening audience that God still loves you. Not your neighbor said he loves you like that. Hallelujah. He said, remind you, he paid so you can have and enjoy the abundant life. The life is full until it's overflowing. And then he said this, and I need to reiterate this, because he said, I've come so you can live a life like you have never dreamed of.
That's
why I played that song. I need you to begin to believe again. I need you to begin to dream again. I need you to start having expectation again that the sky is the limit. And if God owns the sky, that means you can get everything.
That's right.
Tell your neighbor everything. But then today, as I was preparing for the first time ever, I saw this scripture in a whole new light. Go to Ephesians. My God, my God. Hallelujah. And Ephesians, the third chapter, because we always read about the exceeding and abundantly. But then I saw something that I had never saw before, because it was dealing with his love. I said, Lord, give me something else to tell your people about your love. And he said, in 17, may Christ, through your faith, actually dwell, settle down. I'm reading the Amplified version. Abide, make his home in you, and may you be rooted and grounded in love and found in security on love, that you may have the power and be strong to apprehend and grasp with all the saints, God's devoted people, the experience of that love. What is the breadth and the length and the height and depth of it? That you may really come to know and practically do experience for yourself the love of Christ, which far surpasses mere knowledge without experience. He's saying, now I'm about to take you from the information stage to the revelation stage to the manifestation stage. So you're no longer going to just hear what I'm saying. You're going to begin to see what I'm saying. And I'm about to demonstrate how big my love is for you. Amen, somebody. But then he said this. He said, now let me explain what I'm saying. He said, now unto him that's able to do exceeding abundantly above all. He said, first of all, let me tell you, that's attached to my love for you. Hallelujah. Wait a minute. You can't get Ephesians 3:20 if he don't love you. Because he said, this is going to go way beyond you have ever thought before. Yes. Somebody shout glory.
Glory.
Now let me read you an Amplified. Now, but then he says this in 19, that you may really come to know practically through experience for yourself. Tell your neighbor, this is personal right now. Now, this is personal right now. The love of Christ, which far surpasses mere knowledge without experience, that you may be filled throughout your whole being unto the fullness of God, that you may have the richest measure of his divine presence and become a body wholly filled and flooded by his presence. Oh, wait a minute. Y'all didn't catch that? He's saying, I'm ready to take you who is normal and natural, and I'm about to flood you with me, and I'm about to turn who you are from the natural to the supernatural. He said, wait a minute. I'm about to flood you with me. I'm about to drip in you. I'm not about to pour in you. I'm about to flood. Tell your neighbor, it's about to be a flood in you. There's about to be a flood in you. There's about to be a flood in you. And whenever there's a flood, something got to go and something got to come. Somebody shout glory. But then he caps it off like this. Now that you understand, now, as Ask your neighbor, do you understand? Do you understand? Do you understand His love now? Do you understand it? Because one thing is, until you understand His love, you will never understand the magnitude. I deserve to be blessed. Y'all don't feel like that? I said, I deserve to be blessed. I deserve the blessing of the Father. He paid for me to have the blessing. He went through too much for me not to accept all the blessing. Amen. He has already paid the full price. I want everything God got for me. Tell you that I want everything. I want everything. Now, can I give you the measure that He wants to give it? See, you gotta believe this though. If you still thinking in small state, you are in the wrong place. And I ain't talking about the wrong church. I'm talking about the wrong place in Him. Because God is too big for you to think so small. God is too big for me to think He can just take care of my headache and He can't take care of my cancer. So let me show you His unmeasurable love for you. It can't be measured, y'all. I tried to measure. There is no stick that can measure His love. Because you know what? Every time I think God done did His best.
Lord.
Anybody else here? Right when you think He done did all He gonna do, then He mess around and do something else. Now you remember, I'm the one who told Him 20 years ago that I'm mad at you. Love. Jesus. I think the madder I got, the more He wanted to love me. Because He wanted to show me my madness can't overcome His love. I come out to tell you, God love you like that. Jesus. Somebody shout glory.
Glory.
Now let me give you the measurement, because I'm about to bust. Amen. I'm about to bust up in here. Amen. Because there is an anointing in here that I know that there's some miracles about to happen in here. I don't know who need a miracle today. I don't know who need God to do something today. But I decree and declare out of my prophetic mouth that something's going to shift in your life today. God did not send you to 3106 West 73rd or had you turn to Channel 21 at 1 o'clock for you to stay the same. Something's got to shift, and I decree it and I declare it in Jesus' name. This is because every time I try to go to the King James Version, he tell me, you can't read that. I said, why not? He said, because I'm about to amplify. I talk to this kid over here. He's about to make some things bigger. He's about to add some words. He's about to add some dimension. He's about to stretch some things. He's about to go way beyond what He had already said. He is ready to do the unbelievable. How many of y'all believe that today? Habakkuk 1:5 said this. He said if. Jason, even if I tried to tell you, you wouldn't even believe it. When I'm trying to explain to you how big this blessing that the Father is about to pour upon His children, it's going to make the world say, there got to be a God. Today. The mailman don't run. But I looked in the mailbox today. Your mailman won't run on Sunday. My mailman run 24/7. because somebody may have forgot. Because I thought about this morning. I said, when a warm woman, sometimes, and I know some of you women can say this, sometimes you know the day you got pregnant.
Yeah.
You ain't have to wait for no test.
Right.
You got what I'm saying? Man, you made me pregnant. Test. I knew that time I was pregnant with my destiny. And Brother Tim, like the Holy Ghost went to Mary. He said, Mary, you highly favored. And you my favorite. And I decided to impregnate you without a man. Because this thing I'm about to give you ain't gonna be what man can give you. Of his action is able.
Well.
Woo, let me go back. In consequence of the action of his power, that is at work within us. It's in you guys. Listen, it ain't on this outside of you. This power I'm talking about, you ain't got to try to get it. You already got it. And see, we don't know we got it. I keep telling y'all there's something greater on the inside of you. How do I know? Because Jesus said this. He said, listen here, I got to go away because there's one that's greater that I need to send on the inside of you. So you can begin. You got Jesus on the inside of you. You got resurrection power on the inside. You got the power of the Holy Ghost. That's all right. That's all right. Now this is what he said. This is the link. To carry out his purpose and do super abundant. Far over and above. Oh.
Yes.
Wait a minute. What? Some?
Oh.
All some.
Oh.
A little bit.
Oh.
Just a piece of it.
Oh.
Wait a minute. All?
Oh.
How much is all? Listen, this is in you, this is in you. Amen. Wait a minute. I'm fine. And above all, that we dare ask.
Thank you, Lord.
He daring you to.
Yeah.
Oh, I wish I had. Anybody ever dared you before? Like, bro, like, I dare you to hit me. What that make you want to do? Knocked your teeth out. You shouldn't have. I double dog dare. You know, I triple dog. I quadruple dog dare. Yeah. God is saying, I dare you to come and ask me. He said, I dare you, Kelly, to come and ask me. that you ask or think infinitely beyond our highest prayers, our desires, our thoughts, our hopes, and our dreams. Now, I need to go back to one thing. It's all because he loved you.
Yes. Yes.
This was simply the love of Christ and his measurement that he wants to give you. Because he started off with the love of Christ is this. Then he told you what to do. He told you, I'm going to flood you. Then he told you what the flood going to look like. Because he's saying, when I come in you, you can't help but to overflow. Because you can't contain me no how. Because I am God. And since you can't contain me, when you come to me, I put you in overflow status.
Oh.
Tell your neighbor, overflow, overflow. Now, nudge your other neighbor, say, wake up, neighbor, wake up, wake up. That's why I have everybody talking to each other. Wake up, wake up. Should have took that medicine, amen. You should have took that Alka-Seltzer plug. You coming in the house of God now. Nudge your neighbor real good, real good. Tell him, wake up! You sleeping while God trying to talk to you.
My Lord.
Now, then he told us, amen. That's because I love you, amen. Tell your neighbor, Pastor, love you like that. I don't want you sleeping on your blessing, amen, somebody. I don't want you sleeping while God talking to you, man, man. But then he said this because the testimony that God said he's about to give new beginnings is this. We ain't
never.
Oh, no, y'all didn't say it like y'all meant it. What's going to be our testimony?
We ain't never going
to be accessible. Oh, glory be to God. Amen, amen. And tell your neighbor, it's happening.
It's happening.
Amen, I got to tell it, amen. Tell your neighbor, it's happening, it's happening. It's happening right now, amen, it's happening. When people are coming back saying, they are saying that, people are saying that, I have never seen it happen like. So the other day, Prophetess Terry called me, all jacked up, called me on the phone in the middle of a fast, wanted to talk about how good God is.
Amen.
She said, Pastor, I need to tell you something. I said, what's that? They called me in the office today. Mm-hmm. And you know when they call you in the office, go one or two ways. That can either mean you got a job,
or you don't.
Or you don't. Anybody ever been there before with you?
Oh, yeah.
So they call her in office. And she said the lady begins to talk to her. And she said she already knew there was something that she was going to be working on. And the lady began to cry and tell her. She said, listen, you have a promotion with a raise.
All right.
And I don't even know why we're doing it like this. Put in the application, and not only did they give her a job, they gave she's about to get a promotion and a raise, and she didn't believe it. But God said, that's why I gave you Habakkuk 1 and 5. I told you I'm about to do something that you had never thought of, never dreamed of, didn't even put in the application. Now, I want y'all to repeat after me. Say, I believe it.
I believe it.
I receive it.
I receive it.
I conceive it.
I conceive it.
And I decree it.
And I decree it.
That 2015.
That 2015.
I'm going to see this thing.
I'm going to see this thing.
Gonna be epic. And he said to tell you today, don't look at the size part of it. Because what he's about to give you is a story. He's about to give you a story that when you tell the story, they not even gonna believe you. Because they're gonna say, you must be lying. Because there's no oh God, I can't. See, he gon' people when they see the new bread,
that's right.
They think that this is not the real bread. Right. Because if you knew where I came from and where he's brought me from, my story becomes something that people say, I don't even believe it. Right. Sometimes they come to church just to see if I who I said I am. Because you gotta know first whence he brought me from.
Yes.
And then you would understand the miracle that's standing before you. Yes. If it was up to the devil, I would not be here. Yes. But God.
Yes.
I got a but God.
Yes.
But who? But God.
Yes.
So he's about to give you a story.
Thank you, Lord.
Now I got one prophetic word to give you, too. Are y'all ready?
Yes.
Are y'all ready?
Yes.
He gave this to me the other day. I'm going to the word. I already did the word, didn't I? I'm still going to the word. Amen. Because I've been in rhema mode lately. I got to explain this word. I can take you from scripture to scripture to scripture to scripture to scripture. And then I leave you with a lot of scripture, but I don't show you how it works. I'm trying to show you that this thing is acting. It's living. It's not something that we're just reading about. Some people don't believe in miracles. I believe in miracles. Hallelujah. Anybody ever seen a miracle before? I'm going to show you what the miracle is meant to be. The prophetic word for you today. It's done.
It's done.
That's it.
That's it.
It's all
done.
Now, Janae, say it's done. Let me help y'all with something. Your raise is done. Your healing is done. Every promise, every dream.
Yes.
It's already done.
Yes.
Can I help y'all with something?
Yes, sir.
Every one of y'all children already say, it's done.
Yes.
See, it's done. It's done. Yes. Whoever laying in the hospital right now, it's done.
Yes.
He's saying, I'm telling you, it's already done. You ain't got to ask me when I'm going to do it. I'm telling you.
It's done.
Now,
it's done.
The key is, do you believe it?
Yes.
Turn to Mark the 9th chapter, 23rd verse. Ask your neighbor, do you believe it? Do you believe that?
Yes, I do.
See,
amen.
This is what the Lord shared with me this morning. I think now I can preach. Teach, I mean. They laugh at me. This is what the Lord, y'all, I'm going to talk about, y'all find Mark 9th chapter. This is what the Lord shared with me this morning, Jason. He said, many believers don't believe. Mm-hmm. Now, ain't that something? Like, he said, wait a minute. I'm standing there getting ready. Pastor Tim, and he said this, he said, many believers, they don't believe. They believe in salvation, but they don't believe in his power. See, because I say I'm a believer, what am I believing in? See, because most people who got saved, they believe they say. But then when you talk to them about the benefit package, they don't believe that the benefit package belonged to them. So they believe Jesus as a person. But they don't believe in that Jesus in his power. They do. They believe him as a person. They believe him. Even the disciples and the people around the Pharisees say, isn't that Jesus? Mary's son? They knew him in his person. But they would not accept his miracles. Because in his own hometown, he said, I got to leave. Because of their unbelief. Because they didn't believe in him. They just looked at him as mere man. And many people have come to Jesus, but they've never ever walked into his miracle working power. And they think just because they came to church, it automatically make them a believer. Now, when you come to Jesus, you become a believer in Jesus, but that don't mean you a believer in what his works can do. Wow. Are y'all catching what I'm saying? So here we are, and I remember I went to my mom's church, and they had a point where people went down to the altar. And my mom been a member of that church for now probably 60 years. And all the time I've been there, Annette, I've seen the same people go down to the altar and come back the same way. So I asked my mother one day, I said, I see you going down to the altar. Why do you go? She says, because that's just what we do.
All right.
See, and most people come to church because that's just what you do. Because you know on Sunday, you're supposed to go to church because that's just
what you do.
We don't come with an expectation. We just come saying, what you do today? You know I went to church. Let's go to the state store. What? No, let me not. No, none of y'all. But listen, I'm saying that we come to Jesus for his person, but we don't come to Jesus for his power. And I think Paul backed it up like this. He said, I got to get to know him. Because he gave me another revelation. Oh man, this is powerful. Jesus said unto him, if thou canst believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. Now, let me explain that to you. Believing gets you there. Believeth gets you to the end.
All right.
Because see, most of us, we start believing until the storm hit.
That's good.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Right. That's true.
Then once the contrary wind hit, then all of a sudden, we quit believing what we believe for. But now, I want you to know something. He said, now, all things. Tell your neighbor, all things. We got all things. We back to this word, all. You, what we've been hearing. He wants to do all things. He wants to do everything in your life. Now, he's saying, but wait a minute. He said the key to this all things is simply you believing. Right? He didn't say nothing else, did he? Did he say it's how much you jump?
No.
How much you shout?
No.
How many times you fall out?
No.
He says simply it comes from one thing only. They to believe. Now let me keep moving because I can't get stuck there. Y'all got that?
Yes.
Now, in number 24, now check this out. And straightway the father of the child cried, because what Jesus had came, his son had been a lunatic, and he came to Jesus to get his son healed. And nobody could do it, so they went to Jesus. And they're asking Jesus, he's asking Jesus, can you come and heal my son? He asked him to have compassion on him, all that. Then he said, Jesus turned back to him and said, if you can believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. And then number 24, and straightway the father of the child cried and said unto the Lord, he said, what?
I believe.
Wait a minute, wait a minute. Y'all read with me? He said, what?
I believe.
He told him, he said, I believe.
Yeah.
And then he said this, help my unbelief.
Yeah.
So I asked the Lord, I said, why would he say believe and then say, help my unbelief?
Right.
Because once he believed, he saw what he believed. His son came back.
All right.
So when he realized there may be some unbelief somewhere else, so let me just come in this whole gamut. Oh, no, y'all catch this? Let me just come in this whole thing while I'm here, because I believe you, you can heal me of this disease. But while I'm here, help me in my unbelief. Pay Terry's car note and don't believe he'll put gas money in my car. It's easy to have faith for somebody else, but can you have faith for yourself? Let me keep on going. Say help,
help
my unbelief.
My unbelief.
Now the revelation is he's about to take your impossibilities and make them possible.
Thank you, Lord.
When you believe in Mark the 5th chapter, don't turn there. Real side note. Jairus had went to get Jesus to come to his house because his daughter was almost dead. He got in a place with the woman with the issue of blood. And then all of a sudden, while he got finished with the woman with the issue of blood, Angie, this is what happened. The servant came and said, and I know somebody done heard this, late. Why'd you leave the master alone? Because what you done came to him about is already dead.
Amen.
Anybody done got that testimony lately?
Yes.
And this is what Jesus did. The Bible says, and Jesus, ignoring what he heard, he turned to the man. He said, I don't need you to do nothing else but believe.
You,
ignore what you've been hearing. Because what you've been hearing is opposite of what God is about to do. And he ignored him, deacon. And he looked at him and said, I ain't studying what you talking about. I got Jesus with me, and all Jesus wants me to do, tell your neighbor, just believe. Tell your neighbor, just believe. Just believing will turn around your whole situation.
Yeah.
It will turn that thing. And God told me to tell you, Joseph anointing on his believers today. That Joseph anointing means that everything that the enemy has meant for evil, that God is about to turn, he about to turn some stuff around on your behalf. Somebody shout glory. So he's letting you know, and then Message Bible 9:23, go to Luke 1:37. The Message Bible says this: once you believe, anything can happen.
That's right.
Oh, now wait a minute. That's
right.
What's anything, y'all?
Anything.
He's saying, listen, anything can happen if I can just get you to believe. Adrian, you remember when I spoke to you on Tuesday? I said, he can decide to use you as his first person of evidence that he can heal that thing. I saw on Facebook on the other day, they have a sickle cell patient. The first one bona fide that they can say has been healed of that disease. That means the sky
is unlimited.
So, that means everybody under my voice has a black card. Y'all don't watch the famous enough. They're looking at me, what's a black card? Eh?
Yeah.
I ain't talking about your EBT card, amen. Not that black card, not that black card, not that black card, not that one. Not that one, not that one. I'm talking about. Here's where you at. Now I'm explaining where the black card is. Amen, somebody. I'm talking about a card with unlimited.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
When you got a black card,
glory.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
You get preferential treatment.
Yes.
You ain't got to show your license. Just show your black card.
Right.
And all of a sudden, you become Mr. Whoever or Mrs. I'm here to tell you, you have a black card in the heavenly realm that you can swipe anywhere you want and get as much as you want because your Father who is in heaven has unlimited access. And if you can believe it, you can receive with you by yourself. Now let's go to Luke 1:37. And your version says, and with God all things are possible. But I told you, I ain't reading no normal stuff today. The Amplified says this, tell your neighbor, be a believer.
Be a believer.
But who do I need to believe in?
God.
I need to believe in God.
Yeah.
Now listen what he said. With God, nothing is ever impossible. No word from God shall be without power or impossible for fulfillment. He say, in other words, everything I say, I gotta fill it.
Yes. All right.
Every order you bring to me, I gotta send it back to you. Wow. He's saying with me. Now, listen, with me. Now, I ain't talking about by yourself. You done tried to do it by yourself long enough. What he's saying now is when you add me to it. When you add me to it, you already win.
Amen.
Amen.
He said, with God, my word or nothing shall be impossible. And he's about to turn everything around. He's about to turn your lack into overflow. He's about to turn your sickness into healing. He's about to turn your depression into joy and unspeakable joy. He's about to take your measurable and make it unmeasurable. He's about to take your believable and make it unbelievable. How many of y'all believe that today? God is about to do what man cannot do.
Amen.
And then, because that was a story wrapped around Mary.
Yes.
And God coming to her saying, you highly favored. And I'm about to impregnate you. I'm about to impregnate you with something like nobody has ever seen before. And she believed what he said. And Luke 1:45, and it said, and blessed, happy to be envied, is she who believed that there will be a fulfillment. Oh my God, here we go again. There will be a fulfillment of those things that which were spoken to her from the Lord. And I'm here to tell you, God is about to fulfill everything he said. Mark 16:17. Now how do I know I'm a believer? How do I know? Now, I'm going to show you how you know. Man, this is powerful, yeah. Say, Pastor, how I know? Come on, talk to me. Pastor, how I know?
Pastor, how I know?
I'm glad you asked.
Yes. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. I already know what it's saying, but I want to make sure I read it. How do you know? How do you know? How do you see? Because it ain't about what you say.
That's right.
Amen. Because people are always saying they believe. Amen. Now this is what he said, 16 and 17. And these signs.
All right. Yes.
Wait a minute. What signs? These signs shall follow them that believe.
Yeah.
What he's saying is, you need to be a poster board for miracles.
Yes.
Wait a minute. If you believe, how you always say you believe, and you ain't got no sign up saying what you believe in?
That's right.
I believe, but I don't have a billboard up saying these signs. What signs? Signs, wonders, and miracles.
Yes.
Wait a minute. If you a believer, I should see a sign.
Yes.
Go out there to the bar.
Yeah.
I see a sign there drunk.
That's right.
Do I see a sign you a believer?
Right.
These signs shall follow them that believe. Do you believe? Whatever you believe, you'll begin to see. This is our last scripture.
Yes.
Matthew 9:2. Y'all had enough? I'm done. Somebody say, don't say that, Pastor. What I say, if you a believer, what should happen? Somebody should see something. Something should be on you that people know you a believer. Am I right? Because he said these signs shall follow them. You should speak in new tongues. You should cast out demons. You should see the blind, see again. You should see something. If I say I'm a believer, you should see something that I don't believe in. There should be a sign. You should have a sign walking with your life. Then here it is. Because if you believe, somebody should see it. Matthew 9:2. And they brought unto him a man sick of palsy. And he was lying on a bed. Mm-hmm. And Jesus said this. He saw their faith.
Yeah.
I want to ask you this. When is the last time Jesus can say,
my God,
my Lord, I saw
my God.
Your faith?
My God.
Because here they came, full of expectation.
Yeah.
And the reason he worked a miracle is because he knew they believed. I'm done. Let's clap our hands. I want to drop this in you. Come on, y'all stand up and yawn and shake it off. Go on and make it good while the camera don't see y'all. Amen. Amen. This is going to be your final thing that God wants to drop into you. St. John 14 and 12. Man, I don't know why I keep on. St. John 14 and 12. Because this is what we're about to see. Are y'all ready for this?
Yeah.
Are y'all ready? Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, he shall do also. And the greater works than these shall he do.
Yes.
Because I go unto my Father.
Yes.
God is ready. Listen, not for him to do the greater works, but he's ready to manifest the greater works.
Yes.
Through the believer.
Yes. Amen.
How many of y'all want the greater works?
Yes. Yes.
See, you remember where he went to him? You remember back in Mark, the 9th chapter? You can move this. He said this. He said, if you can. And Jesus said this. It ain't on me.
Yes.
Who is it on? Tell you, it's on you. It's on you. He been wanting to do it. He just been waiting for you to believe. Let's bow our heads. Let's play the music, please.
What an awesome word. I know I believe. I know they call us Christians because we want to be Christ-like, and they call us believers because we believe the word. After that powerful message from Pastor Gregory McCurry, you can't do nothing but believe. Amen? Hallelujah. We want to invite you out to New Beginnings Ministries. We're located at 3106 West 73rd Street, right off of Clark on the west side of Cleveland. We have children's church. As today, I'm down here in the children's church. So as the parents were upstairs learning about an awesome word about believing, we were also down here teaching the children about the word of God and how much power is in the blood of God. If you want to make a donation to New Beginnings Ministries, please go to our website. That's www.mynewbeginning.org. Or you can give us a call at area code 216-916-9270. Thank you so much for tuning in. And here at New Beginnings Ministries, we introduce a real God to real people with real issues. Amen. We love you.